that gets us through OSHA, gets us through the I-9, gets us through the tax forms, gets us through having to send the employment security document. And where do we go from there?
Well, let's just briefly cover the Fair Labor Standards Act. And that sets up the requirements, the federal requirements for minimum wage and overtime. There are two levels of protection, you could say. One is the federal government sets its own standards under the Fair Labor Standards Act, and there's the state protection, so the state can create its own laws. The law that applies to you is the law that's more protective of the employee. In New Hampshire, it happens to be that the law right now adopts the federal standards. That means that the New Hampshire wage, minimum wage, is the same as the federal. They've adopted the federal minimum wage, which is $7.25 right now. So you have to pay your employee minimum wage, $7.25. There are also certain overtime requirements that you need to consider as well. However, agriculture labor is exempt. And agriculture, and you can pay an agriculture laborer less than minimum wage, so a wage of your choice, if you meet the exemption. And the exemption is somewhat difficult to understand at first glance, but I'll explain it to you so it's very clear to you, and you will know if you apply, or you will know if the exemption applies to you. It's called the 500 mandate exemption. Sounds a little weird. What it means is that if your farm does not exceed 500 man days in one calendar quarter, then you are exempt from FLSA requirements, minimum wage and overtime requirements. Now let me get down to what one man day is. One man day equals a day where a person on the farm performed farm labor for 1 hour or more.
Okay.
So if you have an employee and they come on and they're harvesting for 50 minutes and then they go home, that doesn't equal a man day. If that person comes on the farm, harvests for an hour and a half or 8 hours or 10 hours, that equals one man day that's used against your 500 man days. So a calendar quarter is a 3 month period. So this means that you can have within the exemption eight employees doing farm labor, working 5 days a week for 12 weeks, which is one calendar quarter, and you're still within the exemption. In fact, it equals 480 days. So you can see that it actually is fairly generous.
Okay. So if you meet that exemption under 500 man days in a 3 month period, then you can choose the hourly wage that you negotiate with your employee. You mean well below minimum wage if you need it to be. And likewise, you don't have to adhere to overtime rules.
Yes, that is correct.
And overtime rules or anything above 40 hours?
In most circumstances.
Even for agriculture?
Agriculture labor, if it's truly agricultural, it's actually exempt from overtime requirements.
It is, okay.
Yeah.
So that's the city field labor. What if I'm a cashier at a farm stand, is that agricultural labor?
That probably will not qualify as agricultural labor. Agricultural labor is specifically defined. There's two different definitions. There's the primary definition, which is farming in all of its different aspects, milking, you know, haying, doing things that are clearly farming activities. There's a secondary aspect as well. And this is doing something in conjunction with a farming, with a farm. It's still farm related, and it's gotta be done by a farmer on a farm. But it's not necessarily the milking of the cow. It might be transporting milk from one location to another or something like that. when it comes to retail activities, probably you are not going to fall within the agricultural definition.
So that's when the overtime would kick in.
Yeah, that's right. And you got to think of the 500 man days as well, because that only applies to agricultural labor.